Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Today we're working on a house out in Waconia. It's a modified two-story with a basement, a full basement under part of the house, and then a slab-on-grade on the other half of the house. It's got aftermarket drain tile, which is kind of unusual for 1994. Typically it would have that right from the get-go. In this instance, we weren't able to get to the garage or a house attic. Above the unfinished portion of the basement is kitchen, so there's no closets or anything we can get up to, and the garage is inaccessible as well. So I'll show you what we've got going on here. So we did have to do one of these super ugly outside systems. I'm not a fan of these, but it was our only choice in this house. And we did go up through the soffit there, and there's our pipe that we painted to match the shingles. So they are not attractive, but sometimes we can't get them all in the attic. So now to show you the basement portion. So we know this is aftermarket drain tile because you can see where the concrete's been jackhammered out and they added the drain tile. It's the original floor, this is the repour. So pretty common, but not in 1994. Here's the sump. We did sump suction on this just because these are so leaky. They have a product called, I call it floor edging, but basically a big air gap behind the wall. So sump suction, we usually don't do that. It's kind of frowned upon, but in this instance, it's the most energy efficient option. So we've got our clear Lexan cover on there and you can see the water in the sump. So our pipe runs up and then we put a T in the pipe with a cap on it, and last night before I left, I set up some radon tests. This is where the pipe goes out to the fan outside that we just looked at, but when I got back this morning to finish it up, we had noticed that the radon levels were all about 1.4, so we know we can do better than that. So I pulled the cap off and we added this 3-inch pipe. They're gonna finish the basement here, so keep it as up and out of the way as much as possible. So it runs over to pick up this slab on grade portion of the house here. So we had some big air leaks to soil. You can see where I foamed some of that. I wasn't able to get it airtight. Probably gonna be hard to see that, but if you got a leak you can't seal, you wanna get away from it with your suction point. So that's why we're over here. So a lot of people ask or are concerned about us digging suction points and concerned about the settling or the concrete falling into the suction point. So it's not really a concern unless the basement floor is only, you know, an inch or two thick. But here I cored through this block wall to pick up the upper portion, and it's gonna be a little bit hard to pick up, but you can see the top of the, right up there is the basement, or sorry, the bottom of the concrete. And then here's the dirt. So you can see there's probably about 2 to 3 inches of settling there. And then at the very far side, you can see the block on the side of the frame there. So what we're gonna do is slide this over and then run a pipe in there. So I've got a damper in there so I can control the flow. I've got a damper on my original suction point as well, and then I'll balance everything out based on my test holes. So as far as test holes, we've got one here, I've got one here, and then this red tube goes down under the stairs here, and then I've also got one upstairs to make sure we're reaching up there as well. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thank you so much for watching.